Now, after several discussions facilitated by the U.S. Treasury Department, the World Bank, Ethiopia, Sudan, and Egypt are hoping to reach a technical agreement by the end of February over the construction of the Grand Ethiopian Dam on the Nile River. Yasser Abbas, Sudan's Irrigation and Water Resources Minister, says the three nations are more than 90% toward a final deal, including a crucial agreement that the dam will release 37 billion cubic meters of water each year. VOA's Jason Patinkin and Nadia Taha spoke with Abbas about the ongoing negotiations.
In Sudan, we see the dam as a potential opportunity for regional cooperation. Of course, the dam has big impacts downstream, both positive impacts and also negative impacts. The positive impacts we have in Sudan is that the dam, it regulates the flow of the Blue Nile, so we'll have more kind of regular water coming along the Blue Nile throughout the year. And that means more hydropower generations and more water supply for irrigation. The negative impacts we have from the dam is that the area of the floodplain agriculture, that is when the water is spilled over the banks, it makes some floodplain area, which our farmers, they used to grow, that become less. So our main concern is that we want to see the three countries agreed on the initial filling, how many years it takes to fill, and how will be the operation afterwards. The situation is that Sudan is not yet consuming its quota. So it's still like 5 or 6 billion meter cube pass downstream. Why is that? Because the storage capacity of the Sudanese dams is small, cannot regulate the water. After the Grand Ethiopian Renaissance Dam, when there is more regulated water coming, Sudan then can consume all its quota, which means that can irrigate more lands, new lands. And as you know, Sudan has very huge arable lands, still not yet cultivated. The Renaissance Dam can be seen as a structure which can strengthen cooperation in the region. For example, Sudan can buy electricity from the dam. Egypt can also buy in the future. Now they don't need, because now they have a lot of generations. But the idea, hopefully, in the future, that because it is cheaper, the power generated from hydro is cheaper than the others. But at the same time, Sudan also contributes to the food security, yeah, of both Ethiopia and Egypt. If you make agricultural lands, it means that you produce foods, you can export to Egypt, you can export to Ethiopia. So the idea is that to encourage or to promote the regional cooperation, the regional benefits from the dam. Not exactly like allocating water, but trying to share or to maximize the benefits and then share it in a win-win kind of scenario.
Our thanks to VOA's Jason Patinkin and Nadia Taha for speaking with Yasser Abbas, Sudan's Irrigation and Water Resources Minister.